Unfortunately, one of the most stressful parts of cosplay happens when your costume is already finished. Believe it or not, making your costume is only half the battle. Getting it to the convention in one piece? That's another story. When it comes to packing for conventions, organization is your best friend. It's easy to lose track of what you need to bring, especially if you're going to be wearing multiple costumes throughout the weekend. Or you're in a packing frenzy because you literally just finished your costumes and you have to leave for the convention in, an hour, and you haven't started packing and you haven't showered in a week because you've been working on costumes and you can't remember the last time you got a full night's sleep. Gotta love that con crunch. To help you avoid the stress of wondering whether or not you remembered a piece of your cosplay, or worrying if your armor is going to survive the trip, or trying to remember where exactly in your five different bags you put your wig caps, here's some advice you can use when packing for your next convention. Keep in mind, this is how I like to pack for conventions. There is no right or wrong way to do it. This is just what I personally like to do.
Step 1, make a list. Before you even open your suitcase, write down everything you'll need for each of your costumes, as well as any other supplies for the weekend. I found it helps to organize my packing list by category, then make note of which luggage each category will go in. If you need a basic packing list to get started, look in the description for a checklist that you can download and print out. Once you have your packing list finished, it's time to move on to step 2, which is to pack each costume in an individual bag. Finally, a use for that strange obsession of storing bags in other bags. I like to set out all of my costumes for the weekend and put them in separate plastic bags so that all the pieces and accessories are in one place. If I have a delicate costume that has to stay in a hanger, that will go in a garment bag. But everything else will go into a large suitcase. Moving on to step 3, shoes and heavier costume pieces go on the bottom of the suitcase. This will prevent any of your fragile things from being crushed. Speaking of which, step number 4, use towels or other soft clothing to protect fragile props and accessories. Again, this will keep them safe if things start shifting around in transit. Number 5, add your costume bags, layering them in order of when you'll wear each costume. So for example, I'll put Sunday's costumes at the very bottom, whereas Thursday's will go on top. This will help you stay organized when you're unpacking at the convention. Step number 6, if you have a separate compartment in your suitcase, it's a good place for things like tights, binders, shapewear, and other undergarments. Number 7, for pajamas and casual clothing, I have a separate carry-on suitcase because I like to keep my giant one just for cosplay. This separate carry-on is also where I keep my makeup cases. Just on the off chance something spills or leaks, this way it won't ruin a costume. So now you know how I pack normal costumes, but armor and oversized props are a little bit trickier. I tend to save armor costumes for conventions I'm driving to so I can transport them in plastic storage bins. I have heard so many horror stories about cosplayers having armor broken or damaged in checked luggage or when shipping it to the hotel, so I do strongly advise avoiding those options if possible. Otherwise, if you do have to bring armor on a plane, invest in a hard shell case that you can check. We'll worry about props in a moment, but first let's worry about wigs instead. If your wigs aren't heavily styled, you can put them in a suitcase, but for wigs that are spiked or put into complicated updos, it's best to transport them on wig heads. I like to arrange mine in a cardboard box that's easy to carry. Other people build custom wig stands for transporting styled wigs, and others even use Build-A-Bear boxes. Back to props. If you have an oversized prop that you can't fit in your suitcase or any other luggage, I usually wrap it in a beach towel or bubble wrap to protect it.
Like I said, everyone has their own method of packing, so use these tips to figure out a method that works best for you. Feel free to share your own cosplay packing advice in the comments, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more cosplay videos. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Mango Cyrene, and as always, happy cosplay. Suitcase. I really don't want to pack a suitcase. I'm not going anywhere.